Imagine a time, long before humans, when the world was a vastly different place. It's a world where the concept of time takes on a whole new dimension. The world where giants roamed the land, ruled the skies, and conquered the depths. It's a realm where these prehistoric giants have left their mark in the very rocks, beneath our feet waiting to be unearthed, as fossils. In 1950, a team of scientists led by paleontologists J. Willis Stovall and Juan Langston Jr. discovered large fossilized bones and tall backbones in the deserts of Oklahoma. These fossils belonged to a new, very large dinosaur species, which they named Acrocanthosaurus atacensis, meaning Atoka's high-spined lizard. This name was inspired by the dinosaur's tall spines and the location of its discovery in Oklahoma. Although initially found in the 1940s, Acrocanthosaurus didn't gain much attention until its rediscovery in the 1950s. Fossils of Acrocanthosaurus have been unearthed in several western U.S. states, including Oklahoma, Texas, Wyoming, and Arizona. Some fossils have even been found in Maryland, a considerable distance to the east. This widespread distribution suggests that Acrocanthosaurus was a highly successful predator. In 2012, researchers discovered the bones of a young Acrocanthosaurus in Wyoming's Cloverleaf Formation. This finding suggests that during the time of the dinosaurs, Acrocanthosaurus was the dominant large predator in that area. The Glen Rose Formation in Texas preserves numerous dinosaur footprints, including those left by large, three-toed theropods. The most famous trackway is in Dinosaur Valley State Park, with some tracks displayed in museums, like the American Museum of Natural History in New York City. Notably, no dinosaur bones were found alongside these footprints, making it challenging to confirm the exact species responsible. Nevertheless, scientists consider Acrocanthosaurus as a likely candidate based on the size and shape of the footprints. In a study conducted in 2001, researchers compared the Glen Rose footprints to those of various large theropods. They found a striking resemblance to the tracks typically associated with Acrocanthosaurus. What's intriguing is that certain theropod prints appear to overlap sauropod prints, implying that the theropods walked there after the sauropods. One theory suggests that these theropods, possibly Acrocanthosaurus, were tracking a group of sauropods. Multiple individual theropods may have walked this route separately, each at different times, after the sauropods had already crossed it. Although it is difficult to be certain. In one spot where a theropod track crosses a sauropod's path, a theropod print is missing. Some scientists propose that this might indicate an attack, with the theropod leaping at the sauropod. Nevertheless, this interpretation is not universally accepted.
In the valley where the lily first flows, where the breeze from the mountain mellows.
Notably, Nothosaurus was a prehistoric marine reptile rather than a dinosaur. It thrived during the Triassic period, which spanned roughly 240 to 210 million years ago. This period also witnessed the evolution and diversification of dinosaurs on land. It is considered a close relative and a possible ancestor of the later marine reptile group known as Plesiosauria. These ancient ocean dwellers resemble today's seals. They reached lengths of about 13 feet, had webbed toes, and possibly sported a fin on their tails. Some grew even larger, up to 23 feet. When swimming, they utilized their tails and webbed feet for propulsion and steering. With broad, flat heads and long jaws filled with sharp teeth, Nothosaurus was well equipped for catching fish and other sea creatures. It is likely that Nothosaurus lived predominantly along coastlines, allowing for easy transitions between land and sea. This adaptability enabled them to dive into the ocean to hunt for prey. Fossil footprints found in China suggest that Nothosaurus used paddle-like motions to dig into the seabed, revealing its hunting strategy for concealed prey. Once Nothosaurus captured something, escaping from its powerful jaws would have been tough. The reproductive method of Nothosaurus remains uncertain, with debates regarding whether they delivered live offspring or laid eggs. Fossils of other Nothosaurus indicate the possibility of live birth, and this method seems to have been prevalent in ichthyosaurs, as well as, potentially in the later plesiosaurs, which are thought to have evolved from nothosaurs. Nonetheless, scientists are still trying to determine when live birth first evolved in marine reptiles. The history of discoveries related to ichthyosaurs is a tale of gradual revelation that spans several centuries. It all began in the late 18th century, when a young girl named Mary Anning unearthed the fossilized skull of an ichthyosaur on the Jurassic coast of England. This remarkable coastal region is known for its exceptional geological significance, featuring a sequence of rock formations spanning the Mesozoic era, which includes the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods. When ichthyosaur fossil was initially discovered, it was nicknamed the crocodile because of its appearance and the fact that people at the time didn't fully understand what it was. They officially received the name Ichthyosauria in 1834. As the 19th century progressed, ichthyosaurs gained scientific recognition as distinct prehistoric reptiles, and paleontologists described and classified various species. Ichthyosaur fossils were found not only in England but also in Europe, North America, Asia, and even Antarctica. Furthermore, in recent times, interest in ichthyosaurs has surged, leading to the identification of over 50 different types worldwide. Subsequently, well-preserved fossils, some even with soft tissues, were unearthed in Germany. These creatures varied in size, ranging from 3 to 66 feet, and exhibited a unique blend of features reminiscent of modern fish and dolphins. They evolved from land reptiles that returned to the sea during the early Triassic, like how the ancestors of modern dolphins and whales transitioned back to the ocean. They possessed flipper-like limbs, sometimes with multiple fingers or a toe in a vertebrate animal's limb, and some sported dorsal fins. Their heads were pointed, equipped with various teeth suited for different prey, and featured large eyes for deep-sea exploration. Characterized by short necks and rigid trunks, ichthyosaurs propelled themselves with a vertical tail fin for powerful swimming. Their backbones were composed of simple discs that extended into the tail fin. They were warm-blooded, air-breathing animals that gave birth to live offspring and potentially possessed blubber for insulation. Ichthyosaurs served as top ocean predators during the late Triassic and early Jurassic periods. Although they were eventually replaced by another group, the Plesiosauria, during the Jurassic, recent research suggests that their decline was not as abrupt as previously thought. They encountered more challenging conditions during the early late Cretaceous, due to change in climates, ultimately leading to their extinction around 90 million years ago. Megalodon was a prehistoric species of shark that lived approximately 23 to 3.6 million years ago during the Cenozoic era. It is often referred to as one of the largest and most powerful predators to have ever existed. Megalodon's name translates to big tooth, which is fitting given its massive size and serrated teeth. The great white shark, which is the closest living relative to Megalodon, typically reaches lengths of 15 to 20 feet. In contrast, Megalodon was significantly larger than the great white shark. While the size of Megalodon can differ, depending on estimates and available fossils, it is believed to have reached lengths of up to 82 feet or even larger in some cases. These prehistoric apex predators inhabited oceans worldwide and likely preyed on seals, bowhead whales, sperm whales, and sea turtles. In contrast to great white sharks, megalodons probably used their formidable jaws to penetrate the chest area and penetrate the heart and lungs of their prey, often demonstrated through bite marks found on the rib cages and other robust bony structures of whale fossils. Numerous excavations have uncovered megalodon teeth near the heavily gashed remains of whales. The presence of bite marks on the roots of the teeth provides additional evidence that the shark's bite was exceptionally forceful, potentially even fracturing the whale's jaw during the attack. Megalodon coexisted with other large marine predators, including killer whales and the newly evolved modern great white sharks. Increased competition for food resources might have put pressure on megalodon populations. Other hypotheses, such as the decline in prey hypothesis, suggests that the extinction of certain large marine mammals, particularly the giant baleen whales, may have played a role in the extinction of Megalodon. Cetiosaurus, which means whale lizard, is one of the early sauropodomorph dinosaurs that lived during the Jurassic period, approximately 166 million years ago. Cetiosaurus is a historically significant sauropod dinosaur, as it represents one of the earliest discoveries in paleontology. These fossils were discovered in England, specifically in the limestone quarries of the Midlands and southern England. Owen's naming of Cetiosaurus marked an important milestone in the field of paleontology, as it was among the earliest named dinosaurs. Richard Owen is best remembered for coining the word dinosauria, which means terrible reptile or fearfully great reptile. He is also known as an outspoken critic of Charles Darwin's theory of evolution by natural selection. In 1841, Sir Richard Owen, a prominent British paleontologist and anatomist, formally described Cetiosaurus based on a limited collection of fossilized bones and teeth. Initially, Owen misinterpreted Cetiosaurus fossils as belonging to an extremely large crocodile-like reptile when he first described them in 1841. Nevertheless, at that time, the field of paleontology was still in its early stages, and scientists were just beginning to understand and classify prehistoric creatures. It wasn't until later discoveries and more complete specimens were found that scientists realized Cetiosaurus was, in fact, a land-dwelling dinosaur, specifically a sauropod. Cetiosaurus was an herbivorous dinosaur with a long neck and tail, typical of sauropodomorphs. While it shares some characteristics with later, more famous sauropods like Brachiosaurus and Apatosaurus, Cetiosaurus was relatively smaller. It reached lengths of about 15 to 20 meters and stood on four sturdy legs. One of the distinguishing features of Cetiosaurus was its small head, which was mounted on a long neck. Its teeth were adapted for grinding plant material, suggesting a herbivorous diet. These dinosaurs were adapted to feeding on plant material such as ferns, cycads, and conifers. Over time, numerous species were attributed to Cetiosaurus, although it's considered a wastebasket taxon, or in other words, scientists are uncertain about their classification due to its diverse groupings. Fossilized remains associated with Cetiosaurus have also been found in France, Switzerland, and Morocco. Argentinosaurus fossils, some of the largest dinosaur remains ever found, were unearthed in the late 1980s in Argentina's Patagonia region, particularly in Neuquén province. While Cetiosaurus measured around 50 to 60 feet in length, Argentinosaurus reached astounding lengths of approximately 70 to 100 feet, making it significantly larger. During the late Devonian period, which stretched from about 358 to 382 million years ago, Dunkleosteus, a massive, armored fish, thrived. This prehistoric giant, with some individuals reaching lengths of up to 33 feet. They possessed a distinctive appearance, characterized by their heavily armored heads, adorned with thick bony plates. In contrast to typical teeth, their formidable jaws were equipped with bony plates, specifically designed for slicing through prey. As a dominant predator of its era, Dunkleosteus likely preyed upon smaller fish, early sharks, and other marine creatures that inhabited the Devonian seas. Fossils of Dunkleosteus have been discovered on various continents, including North America, Europe, and Africa.
The breeze from the mountain, there up as arrows, if I ever leave.